Hey guys, it's Janice Silver, and today I want to talk to you about how to get your seller's permit in the state of California. Now, a seller's permit is a state license that allows you to sell items at either the wholesale or the retail level. Now, obtaining a seller's permit registers you with the CDTFA, the California Department of Tax and Fee Administration, and you must then pay sales tax on all of your taxable sales. So when you sell or lease merchandise, vehicles, tangible personal property in California, even if it's temporary, you are generally required to register with the CDTFA and pay sales tax on your taxable sales. Now, generally speaking, if you make three or more sales in a 12-month period, you are required to hold a seller's permit. Now, this applies even if your sales are made through an internet auction house or websites that offer online classified advertisement. Now, you guys, the exception to this rule is if you are selling using a marketplace facilitator. So what's a marketplace facilitator? Well, a marketplace facilitator is a third-party organization that transacts your sales for you, that also collects sales tax for you, and also remits that sales tax over to the CDTFA on their own. If you're selling through a marketplace facilitator, you are no longer seen as the retailer. The marketplace facilitator is seen in the eyes of, for tax purposes, as the retailer. They're the ones registered with the CDTFA, they're the ones collecting the sales tax, and they're the one remitting the sales tax over to the CDTFA at tax time. Now, you are then known as the marketplace seller. As of 2019, the Marketplace Facilitators Act was enacted, which no longer requires sellers to register with the CDTFA, unless the marketplace seller also makes sales that are not hosted by a marketplace facilitator. So that means that if you sell on a website such as Etsy or Amazon, and you only sell there, you are working with a marketplace facilitator. You are not doing any additional outside sales, therefore you are not required to register with the CDTFA and get a seller's permit. However, if you are making sales not only on a marketplace, but also on your own separate platform or through a third-party site that is not a marketplace facilitator, such as a website that is publishing classified listings or sharing your content on a larger platform, but they're not collecting and remitting the sales tax, then you still do need to file for your seller's permit and pay tax to the CDTFA. Now you guys, keep in mind that making sales of merchandise, goods, or other items in California without first getting a seller's permit violates the law and subjects you to fines and penalties. So it's very important that you check with your own CPA, your own certified tax professional, and make sure that you are compliant with all laws as they pertain to your own individual business. It's important to keep in mind that a sale occurs in the state where the merchandise is physically located at the time that the sale takes place. Now, California sales tax is imposed on retailers and generally applies to their gross receipts from retail sales of merchandise located in the state. So, you guys, how do you obtain a seller's permit? Well, I'm going to show you how to walk through the full application online right now. Okay, you guys, so I'm going to show you exactly how to obtain a seller's permit. I'm going to go ahead and drop this link in the video description down below, but we're at cdtfa.ca.gov. Now, from this page, we're going to scroll down and we're going to click on register or apply for a new business activity or location. We're going to click selling items or goods in California, which is applying for a seller's permit. Now, if any of these other categories are applicable to you, you'll make sure to check them and click next. Next, you're going to be asked a series of questions. Are you selling alcoholic beverages? Are you selling tobacco products? Are you selling tires? Are you selling electronic devices? Go ahead and click next. Does your business activity include fuel products, selling lumber, retail sale of prepaid wireless, selling or manufacturing of lead acid batteries? And click next.
What type of business are you registering this activity for? Now, this is where you're going to select the entity type for your business. Now, so next you're going to be asked some identification questions. You're going to be asked for either a taxpayer ID or a social security number, and you're going to go ahead and enter that in. Next, you're going to be asked here for an FEIN number. Now, an EIN number is a federal employer identification number. That's not required for you. So if you do have one, you can go ahead and enter it in here. And if you don't have one, you can go ahead and skip it. The same is true for the SEIN, which is a state employer identification number. You can go ahead and skip that as well. Next, are you changing from one type of business entity to another? Enter which type of ID you are going to be inputting, and you are going to select the state for that driver's license number, and you're going to input your driver's license number here. You are going to confirm that yes, you would like to apply for a seller's permit and click next. Now, next you're going to be asked if you would like a temporary permit. Now, temporary permits only last 90 days. So most likely you will want to answer no to this question. You will answer no to this question if you want a permanent ongoing seller's permit. But if you want your permit to expire after 90 days, you'll select yes. Next, you are going to be asked, will the business be accepting credit card payments, yes or no? If you select yes, you're going to be asked for a merchant card processor name and a merchant card processor account. Now, you can advance through the application without entering in this information. So you can skip it and bypass it if you do not currently have your credit card processor set up. However, if you do have it set up, this is where you will input that information. Next, they're going to ask you, are you making internet sales? If you select yes, you will then be asked, are you making internet sales through a third party? A third party would be a marketplace such as Etsy, eBay, or another seller's marketplace. If you select yes, then you are going to have to provide the third party site, which you plan on using. Now, if you do not quite have your website all put together yet, you are going to enter in your domain where you plan to have your website. And under the third-party site, if you don't have that set up yet, you can just type in the generalized third-party website, and that should suffice. Next, you're going to be asked for your NAICS code. This is the code for the type of business that you are operating. So you are going to do a keyword search for your type of business. Type in the type of business that you have. You'll go ahead and click on the corresponding code, scroll down, click OK, and it's going to input it for you. Go ahead and click Next. Next, you'll be asked, does your business conduct any of the following business activities? Answer yes or no according to your business. Next, you're going to be asked for location information. So is the location of your business temporary for a temporary event? Yes or no? You will then enter in your business street, address, city, state information. Next, you're going to be asked for your doing business as, your DBA, or your fictitious business name statement. Now, your business name needs to line up with what you have listed on your business license and with your DBA or your fictitious business name. So if you are a sole proprietor and you're doing business under your own first and last name with nothing extra, nothing changed added onto it, then you do not need to file a DBA statement. You can go ahead and enter in your first and last name here. But if you are doing business under a different name that is not your first and last name, you will need to type in what that name is here, as well as file a DBA with your city. Please note that stating your business name here on the seller's permit does not legally claim that as your doing business name with your city. That is a separate filing that you'll need to do. Next, you're going to enter in the date that you would like your seller's permit to start. Click, are you buying or transferring an existing business? Now, you are going to type in your projected monthly sales. Now, the CDTFA doesn't need an exact number here. You are just, most likely, if you're filing for a seller's permit, you're just starting your business. So give a really rough estimate. You will later claim the actual amount when you file your sales tax. So don't stress over this amount. Just go ahead and do a rough estimate. Do you anticipate $0 in monthly sales? Hopefully not. Projected monthly taxable sales. So Your monthly sales are the total amount of sales, including tangible items and services and anything else you might be taking in money for. Now, your taxable sales are going to be the amount that is subject to sales tax, meaning tangible products or services that were worked into the creation of a tangible product. So go ahead and estimate that here. Do you anticipate $0 in monthly taxable sales and products that will be sold during the course of business? Go ahead and enter in a few of the products that you anticipate to be selling. Next, you are going to select where you do and keep your records. So if it is the address you provided, you are going to check that box. And if you are going to be keeping your records at a different address, you will click add a different address. Next, you're going to be asked to provide your supplier's information. This is going to be the companies that you purchase supplies for to either create your product or resell to your clients and customers. Now, if you're a new business, you most likely might not have your sellers ready to go. You may not have already purchased from them, but what they want here is they want one supplier at a minimum that you plan to purchase from. So if you aren't sure, look somebody up, look up a supplier, and whatever you plan on selling, find someone in that category, take their business information, and go ahead and use it. Next, they're going to give you a summary, including the start date of your seller's permit and your reporting basis. Now, a reporting basis is the frequency at which you must report your sales tax and pay your sales tax to the CDTFA. Now, most people will be on a quarterly reporting basis. Now, I acknowledge that I've read and understood the above account information. Select yes and click next. Next, you're going to provide your own personal name, your role in the application, your email address, as well as some contact info. Next is your declaration of intent. Make sure you read this and make sure you check it and click next. This states that you are intending to register for a California tax or fee permit license and or account with the California Department of Tax and Fee Administration. Once you click next, you are going to be confirmed that your application has been submitted. Now, once you have completed filing your application, you want to then create a registration for an account on the CDTFA so that you have an online portal to manage your account. So what you're going to do next is you are going to go down here. You're going to click sign up for a username. Click that you are the owner of a business. Click next. Now, most likely you have not received a security code yet. They must mail you to your mailing address a security code, and you must then use that code to finish the online registration process. So you're going to click yes or no if you've received the code. You are going to click next. You are then going to input your information here. Select your account type, which will be sales and use tax, and input your account number here. Click submit, and then within several weeks, you will receive in the mail a letter with that security code so that you can complete the process of setting up your account online.
Okay, you guys, I hope that was helpful. Please click like, subscribe, and leave me a comment down below. As always, I try to be very active in the comments. I'll try my best to help point you in the right direction with your questions.